Why don't we see ghosts every day?
Ugh, leave me alone.
Most hauntings are so small, they go unnoticed.
Hi, this is Rose's driving school.
Maybe you could have a chat with my daughter, just to find out what's up with her.
My name is Martin.
Oh, Jesus, Mary and Joseph! Martin, she's floating! She's floating, Martin!
I know.
What is evil?
Hey, dinner!
Coming, my sweet! I'm doing an incantation!
Now!
Hear me, powers of the night! The blood moon is nigh!
This bloody moon better make me bloody rich!
Yes. This is a satanic ritual.
Satanist!
I woke up in the morning.
To break the spell, baby, we need ectoplasm. You just have to let the ghost inhabit your body.
Like in Ghostbusters.
Oh, I haven't read that.
The plot thickens.
Why does it have to be so unnecessarily gross?
That magic!
Aha! Uh-huh. Your girl's got something.
Prick.
Holy shit!
Black magic!
This is over.
Your Excellency, a little bit about the project of your embassy in here. We know that we had for several years so the film festival in here. You have the joys every time, which is a joy for us all. And I was so glad when I've been to his tower, and I was so impressed by everything in there. I'm wishing everybody to be one day in there and to feel so extraordinary. So to go on with the title of your film you offered out, it's a very nice Christmas gift, I think, for this year. So,
well, again, thank you, Irina. I suppose one of the things we missed this year was St. Patrick's Day. It is a huge tradition for us and for...
Being in March, it was immediately...
It was immediately. I think it was the first national day that was actually cancelled. So hopefully next year we will be able to make up for that in some way.
Mm-hmm.
But I suppose we took the opportunity this year to do, I think, a little bit more for Bloomsday.
Mm-hmm.
The commemoration of Ulysses, James Joyce's book. So we did a little bit more, as you say.
And we have plenty of time now to read even a little bit more of Joyce, I suppose.
Well,
yeah?
It's funny, when you talk about comedy, people don't generally associate Joyce with comedy, but some of the pieces of Ulysses are so funny and are really so good that people should kind of take in that side of Joyce as well, I think, a little bit more. But in terms of what we propose to do, I suppose, again, this year, it was all about the film festivals in some ways.
You have Rishnov and you also have...
With Timișoara.
Timișoara.
And we have this one. And we also have the Jewish Film Festival. We have an Irish film in the Jewish Film Festival.
Which one?
Next week. Well, it's actually a small film from about 20 years ago about the Irish community the Jewish community in Ireland.
Wow.
And it's called Shalom Ireland.
Shalom Ireland, that's
Shalom
good,
Shalom Ireland. And it's actually a really nice film. I really would encourage people to look at it because it just demonstrates the real joyful contribution that the Jewish community have made to life in Ireland. Over the past 100, 120 years, they came to Ireland from Lithuania in the late 1800s, the main part of the Jewish community. And they've just made such a fantastic contribution to every aspect of Irish life. And this film reflects that. So it's a small film, but again, it's part of this year, where this year has been, we have, as a diplomat, it's been very difficult. What we do is talk to people most of the time. And it's just been very difficult. And of course, it's been a very interesting time in Romania with local elections. More elections coming up. Mm-hmm. So all of the politics of a country are really interesting for us as well. And the other aspect of what we try to do is business and just increase the links between countries and a business
especially
like
now.
Especially now. And especially now because we have such really valued Romanian community in Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
And we've, as you know, a long history of immigration from Ireland.
Yeah.
But one of the things that really reinvigorated Ireland was the return of some of our diaspora. And also the investment of our diaspora in Ireland later on when they became established in the countries that they had moved to. And it became a really important part of Irish life. And I think this will be a feature of Romanian life in the future. It's inevitable.
It's already started a little bit. But I think that is very interesting because some of our Romanian are going to Ireland. Some of the Irish, they went to the States. We've got Scarlett O'Hara, which was recently was forbidden but reopened. So yes, re-permitted after
that's
a
funny.
Certain period.
Because
yes, so it's exactly just a little bit that we are a little bit late compared to you. But history, it's
History catches up.
Yeah.
But as well as that, you have. Mm-hmm. In an unusual twist, you have Romanian people who were working with Irish companies in Ireland coming back as managers of those companies in Romania. And that has started to happen. Mm-hmm. And there are some of those companies I know because I've met them in Cluj. So this and you have a lot of Irish companies here who are managed by Romanian people and Romanian women in particular, which is an extremely positive, I think, development because it really shows just how societies everywhere are changing and are becoming more normal, with the role of women becoming more important in business and in management, and the role of people coming from other countries and the positive role they can play in a country's development. And this is something that has been extremely positive for Ireland over the last 20 years. But getting back to some of the projects we do have plans for next year. We are looking and hopefully the situation with the pandemic will have improved by March the 17th.
Yeah.
So that will be St. Patrick's Day again.
We are hoping that because already the Berlin announced their festival and it's in February. So March is already 1 month later.
Hopefully.
So if they have the courage to announce that, it means it is going to happen. Yeah. So
we did have the opportunity this year to sponsor a book by Dan Nita, a Romanian author who has written a book in Romanian about Dublin. So we have people will be able to access that book hopefully or buy it hopefully and
For sure because it's Christmas so we have to put it on
absolutely.
The list for Father Christmas and by the way how about Christmas how is Christmas in Dublin
well a normal Christmas in Dublin
a normal Christmas in Dublin is
fantastic it's where everybody who can who has been abroad comes home. So we actually have a huge number of people who return to their families to spend Christmas with them. Dublin is just a very lively place anyway, and it just becomes full of life at Christmas.
Okay.
So it is a huge time for family and for friends and for just getting together and people coming home.
And a special dinner or something?
Well,
something specific
that is
for
festive.
What is for?
Oh, absolutely. We take our Christmas dinners very seriously.
Mm-hmm.
There is ham, there is turkey, there is stuffing, there is all sorts of Christmas cake,
Christmas pudding.
Christmas pudding, all of the trimmings. It is a fantastic day for everyone.
And to drink.
And, well... It has been known to happen in moderation.
Yes, of course.
But I think we're pretty well in tune with every place else in Europe now in terms of drinking at Christmas. And it's these days, I suppose people are always conscious of not taking too much alcohol and also being responsible at Christmas. And also, it's always a time where families, it's a time that families need to enjoy. And sometimes alcohol can be an over
Usually children are writing to Father Christmas?
Oh, absolutely. It's just such an important time for children and families. Mm-hmm. And it is one of the things you miss when your children grow up, that you don't have that experience anymore.
But do they have, like in France, I mean, there is Father Christmas coming for Christmas and also for adults for the 1st of January, or everybody all together?
No, I'm afraid we don't have that tradition. I think Father Christmas is really for children, and it's just Christmas.
Unfortunately. And is in the Christmas Eve on the 24th or on the 25th?
No, it's Christmas Eve.
Absolutely. And in the night?
Christmas
or
Eve,
in the morning?
In the night, that night.
In the night, okay.
It's a very important time for, for everyone.
And it's under the tree, or?
Well, obviously, as you know, or at least in Ireland, he comes down the chimney, and
then the presents are
just put under the tree.
Under the tree. Okay, so you're not putting the socks there. So.
Oh, the socks are there as well, but there's always room for more. He needs to put things in socks.
With clover. They have to be green.
Shamrock is our spring.
Yeah.
And spring heralds a new time. And yeah, shamrock is important for our...
And a good luck sign, as we have it. We also have it, you see. There are so many habits that we have on both sides. I must admit, I was very happy in Dublin after... saying that there are not enough film festivals. I've never been to Ireland. I've been once, but not for a film festival. I've been in there with reading for children from Queen Mary of Romania. Yeah. So it was totally different, but it was wonderful. And I know the Romanian community in there, they are feeling like home in there. Yeah. So I hope you also felt like home with us today, and thank you so much, Your Excellency.
Thank you so much.
And happy holidays, as they can be this year. And asta seară, film irlandez, extraordinar, extraordinary. Da, se scrie în două cuvinte pentru că este și paranormal. Cu fantome, altfel decât cele de Halloween, știa, oricum a trecut, dar fantomele rămân cu noi și peste an. E important e de văzut cam cum reacționează ei verzulii când vine vorba de așa ceva. Năluci, înspăimântătoare sau, dimpotrivă, cum poți să-ți dregi cariera cu un sprijin nu neapărat la ghicitoare, farmece și altele. Nu, ei merg la faza următoare. Cu destul de multă ironie la adresa pericolelor de gen, pentru că își pot permite... Și exorcistul mai ales, dar avem ca de fiecare dată cineva care face legătura dintre lumi. De fapt, frontiera e foarte ușor de trecut și nu-ți cere nimeni viză. În plus, aveți grijă cum vă purtați cu cei din jur ca să nu vă bântuie prea mult. O să învățați și o tehnică de intrarea dintr-un trup într-altul. Mă rog, nu e o tehnică chiar foarte elegantă și personal ectoplasma aia nu mi-am imaginat-o chiar așa, dar și ei spun din când în când. Am să ignor partea asta pentru că merită restul. Și asta mi-a amintit de fantoma lui Cathy King. Toată lumea vorbea despre ea și în București se făceau serii întregi de spiritism cu o masă fără cuie. Nu vreau să vă dau idei, nu. Vreau doar să aveți oarecare detașare. Pentru cartea cu pricina, nimeni altul, pentru că apăruse până în război, până în al doilea război, Ion Popescu Gopo făcuse și desenele dintre cele mai izbutite, nu? Pentru că vorbim de filme. Extraordinar, irlandezul, cum spuneam, nu încurcați cu scoțienii, ei aveau de obicei castelele cu fantome, dar ce noi n-avem, doar că Nu știu de ce, nu ne-a dat prin minte să facem un film pe subiect, dar poate asta o să inspire pe cineva. Până una alta, vizionare plăcută și ușor înfricoșătoare. Nu, că e o comedie. Trebuie luat totul ca atare. Dar ca de obicei, e și de învățat. Extraordinar!
Thanks, Irina.